Sachsenring circuit. The waiting is finally over. The German MotoGP Grand Prix will be starting in just a few minutes. The weather forecasts are very reassuring. We will have sunny weather for the entire duration of the race. Everything is ready to start here at Sachsenring. Concentration is at the max because it's extremely important not to lose positions early on this track.
Here in Germany.
Good launch from the middle of the front row by Hector Marquez. Rossi going to last in Marquez. Rossi though will have the inside line as the Italian just getting his nose wiped though by Marc Marquez. Marquez, the pole man, leads. Rossi pushed out a bit wide. He stays in second place. Petrucci up to third.
Yeah, Petrucci almost got through on Rossi as well, didn't he? Wise, he didn't try to make a move. Down at the bottom of the Omegan curve. Through the spray, Marquez leads. Rossi coming under enormous pressure. Danilo Petrucci about hanging on well there in a third place. Is it Andrea Iannone that's got up the inside of him? It is. It's a great start by Iannone. Dovizioso in third. Rossi had the inside line in the Omega corner. He took the lead from Marquez and at turn number three. So Rossi it leads down through this turn number seven for the first time. Coming up to turn eight, where Marquez crashed into the wall this morning. Dovizioso's a man on the charge. He's up the inside of Marquez at turn number eight. Dovizioso then up in a second place. He's come from seventh on the grid. Dovizioso means business, pushes Marquez out of the way. Then he plunges down the hill now. The two left, and then down the right, down the waterfall. Aptly named today. Jack Miller is up from 16th place into 8th. Miller's the man on the charge. Can Dovizioso make a move? Petrucci's up the inside of Dovizioso. No, he's made a move on Marquez though. Marquez pushed back to 4th place by Petrucci. Rossi under pressure from the two Ducatis.
Up to turn 13, final corner, 29 laps to go. Marquez fights back through turn 13. It's Rossi though that leads the way up for the first lap here in the spray at the Sachsenring. Down towards turn one they come. Dovizioso thinks about it on the brakes and then decides plenty of time. Petrucci fights back against Marquez. Marquez holds his third place.
Jack Miller is up into sixth place. He's picked up 10 places on the opening lap of this race. The winner in similar conditions 3 weeks ago at the Dutch TT in Assen. Jack Miller already up 10 spots. What about Jorge Lorenzo? Lorenzo's down in 11th place. That's where we started this race. Danny Pedrosa, haven't mentioned him. He was quickest in the morning walk. Pedrosa in 9th, making no real impression off that fourth row of the grid.
Yeah, disappointing also for Scott Redding, down in 17th place, who fancies himself in the race.
Now, also remember the likes of Petrucci, Miller and Iannone, they are all a step harder on that front tyre than Rossi, Dovi and Marquez.
So, Valentino Rossi, 5 times winner here at the Sachsenring, leads the way. He worked way back in 1999 on a different circuit to this one. Wasn't as long when he won the 250cc race. Here comes Dovizioso on the inside.
Can't quite find a way through as they plunge down the waterfall. Aptly named corner in these conditions here with the Sachsenring. Again, Dovizioso just thought about a move up the inside, but Rossi so strong on the brakes. Petrucci back into third against Marc Marquez with that hard front tyre on. Petrucci just has a bit of advantage in the braking zone. Marquez fights back again at turn number 13. This is a move they've already exchanged a couple of times in this race. Hard but clean from Marquez.
2 laps gone, Rossi leads the way. There is Hector Barber, just behind Hector Barber. Would you believe it's the 21-year-old from Townsville, Australia, Jack Miller. Behind him, you've just got a glimpse there of Andrea Iannone.
Miller, the fastest man on track. There you can see on the screen, 135, 177, 4/10 of a second quicker than Valentino Rossi. Rossi doing what he did in Assen, leading the race. Johnny Hernandez has crashed out at the final corner. The man who led for 9 laps in that part one in Assen 3 weeks ago. That's ended in the same result, unfortunately. Hernandez is on the floor at turn number 13. Lorenzo then up inside the top 10. He just made a move on Maverick Vinales. The Suzuki struggling again in the wet. Vinales 11th place, Spire below 12th.
The clutch down through turn 7 to turn 8. This is where Marc Marquez crashed this morning, where Jorge Lorenzo crashed yesterday. Rossi still leads the way. This is the corner that Dovizioso likes. He likes Rossi. Here he comes again. Has he made it stick? Side by side, Dovizioso leads as they go down the waterfall for the third time.
Dovizioso got a brilliant drive coming out of turn number 8. Just swept up the inside of Rossi. No problem whatsoever. So Dovizioso leads for the third time. Petrucci's been strong on the brakes down into turn 12. He pushes Rossi back to third. So Rossi in three corners has gone from first to third. Miller's made his way through on Barbara. Jack Miller then up to fifth place. Andrea Iannone still right in this podium battle. Iannone's got 2.7 seconds up on Colin Spargaro. What can Rossi do then? Can he fire back against the two Ducatis?
Over the start-finish line they go. 27 laps to go already. A super race. Here comes Rossi up the inside of his great mate Petrucci. Thinks about second about it. Seven riders really in with this one. Petrucci now has set the fastest lap of the race. A 1:34.929 for the Pramac Ducati rider.
So it was a little bit wide going into that first corner. He was able to pull it back to the apex. No way through to Petrucci, but Petrucci now glued to the back wheel of that factory Ducati. There is Johnny Hernandez. A short push back to the pits after that crash in the final corner. Jack Miller then next to his sights of Marquez. Petrucci. Vizioso, that was brave and ambitious. Bit of a twitch for Vizioso as he got on the gas, asking for the power coming out of turn 6. He didn't lose the lead though. This is the sector of the circuit where Vizioso has been supremely strong.
So as they come up to turn 8, it's these left-handers uphill, continue to climb from the top of the hill. It's 9 and 10, then the plunge down to 11. He's absolutely superb here. As you can see, he has pulled a few metres on Danilo Petrucci as they get up to turn 8 and 9. Petrucci's good on the brakes. Look at him down at turn 12. Valentino Rossi's favourite overtaking place. Will Petrucci come? Here he comes!
Yeah, brilliantly up the inside of Vizioso. You've got to be good on the brakes to outbrake Andrea Vizioso. He's one of the latest breakers in MotoGP. No problem though for Petrucci. He leads the German Grand Prix. Pramac Ducati joined the moment. It's the GP15, last year's factory bike for Petrucci that leads this race.
That goes just a quick word. Johnny Hernandez did come jogging up pit lane. The team had his second bike ready and he's just heading back out on track.
34.3 last time around for Petrucci. 0.7 seconds quicker than Vizioso. The fastest lap again. From the Italian.
He is on fire, Danilo Petrucci led the way in Ass and then had his mechanical problems. Second, you remember, behind Valentino Rossi in Silverstone. Very, very similar conditions. Missed the first part of the season with a horrible hand injury.
Yeah, an independent team winner for the first time in 10 years, last time out in Assen. We've got an independent team rider leading this Sachsenring race. It's Danilo Petrucci. He thought he should have been in this position in Assen a few weeks ago. In that part one, he set the fastest lap of the race. He's great in the rain. Only mechanical ruled him out of the second race. Petrucci now, he's already been able to stretch out just over 0.4 seconds over Dovizioso.
There's Jack Miller, Hector Barber behind him. Jack Miller in fifth, Hector Barber sixth. He's just got a glimpse of Andrea Iannone. I think it's Danny Pedrosa, is it? Closing up on Iannone. It certainly is, but he's 3 seconds down on the leaders. Danny Pedrosa is good round here and good in the wet conditions.
Yeah, Danny Pedrosa is probably with his weight. He's having to wait a little bit longer than some of it, gives him a bit of heat into those tyres. We've seen Danny Pedrosa so often come on really strong in the second half of the race. There's still an awful long way to go here in Germany. 25 and a bit laps as Scott running up the inside of Jorge Lorenzo at the first corner. Just to make Lorenzo pick up his knee. Down with an eager turn, actually, for Lenny. End of lap 5, then it's still Petrucci that leads the way. Vizioso now quickest on circuit with a 1:34.2. She just 3/10 seconds away. She's settled down now in this lead group. They should have holding stage a little bit. Petrucci from Vizioso, Rossi. They're just closing up a fraction on Marquez.
I think they've just sounded out the conditions a bit, don't you? They're just settling into some sort of rhythm now. Vizioso looks pretty comfortable in second place. Rossi quite happy in third. They just bide their time. Marquez as well. Miller's done what he made out to do. That was make a good start and get in with this leading run. He might have a quiet period of calm for a couple of laps. Probably not. But let's just wait and see. They go down to 2-7. 24 and a half laps to go. Andrea Iannone has only made a better qualifying. Only had a crash in qualifying. He's going to be right up there with him. And there is Danny Pedrosa. Let's keep an eye on him. 4 times MotoGP winner here, second in the last 2 years.
Pedrosa, just another half a second behind that there. There's a Spargaro. Under pressure again from Reading. Those two had a great battle for the
spun. Spargo in ninth. Millen out the inside of Marc Marquez. Jack Miller then is up into fourth place. Just thought he might be running a little bit wide. Pulls him back through turn number 12. We've seen Marquez retaliate a couple of times on Petrucci in turn 13. Miller's got the edge.
Certainly has got the edge, and now Marquez is coming under pressure from Hector Barbera. And you've got to say, absolute deja vu the way he went past Marquez that time, right?
Well, the thing is, it hasn't really rained since the start of the race, so that's why the guys that would have gone with that harder option front tyre, as Miller told us on the grid, they'll be generating too much heat for the softer guys, and that's not going to play into their hands. The guys that did choose it, Dobby, Rossi, Marquez, they will actually be hoping to put some more rain.
Just good in that final sector. Last time around, he took almost 3/10 of a second out of Dovizioso. To Barber, just a fraction wide in the corner. So next camera, Miller, come down. Looks like Polis Marquez got, but it was just taking Polis Marquez at ninth place at turn three. The gap between Miller and Rossi is 1.1 seconds.
Trucci still leads the way. Safe best ever result in the rain at Silverstone last season. Dovizioso has made the same choice, I think, Dylan.
No. Dobby's on the beat. He's on the softer option.
Sorry.
So,
right.
So is Rossi. Miller is on the harder. Marc is on the softer. Barber is softer.
Go to see the party at the podium. Let's take a look at the MotoGP class final results. Third place is good for the team's morale. 16 points more in the ranking and the knowledge that the rider bike unit is extremely competitive. The top three riders take to the podium. Vinales wasn't expected to win today, but he did. Very well done, Maverick.